Hey guys, Mike Binder here with MGB Music Lessons. I'm going to show you how to play Wolves by Selena Gomez and Marshmello. So this is a really cool concept. I love these chords. They're very dreamy. There's lots of overlap, overtone, and dissonance. And these are the type of chords that you do not see in music books. So it's a really cool technique, and I'm going to break it down for you. I'm going to show you the whole arrangement. So we're going to go up to the 7th fret with our middle finger, and we're going to play this really cool B minor chord. So our middle finger is on the low E 7th fret, and our ring finger is on the G string 7th fret. Now our thumb is always going to do quarter notes like this. In between those quarter notes, we're going to add in with our index finger. So it goes thumb, index on the G, thumb, index on the B string. And you just alternate like that. Now this shape is a minor shape. It takes up one fret. The fingers are both on one fret, the 7th fret. Now to make it a major, we're gonna go up here to D, and we're gonna do a similar shape, but we're gonna take up 2 frets, okay? And we're on the 10th fret and the 11th fret to do this D major. And it's gonna be the same picking pattern. Okay, then we're going to go down to the 3rd fret and do that same major shape we did up here, but down here. And just remember, the major shape takes up 2 frets. So the minor takes up 1 fret on the 7th. The D major takes up the 10th and the 11th fret. And then the G takes up the 3rd and 4th fret. So the shape's similar in the sense that you're pressing down the same strings. It's just one is a single. I like to call this a single because you're only on 1 fret, and then these majors are doubles, okay? Now, this is just an option. You don't have to, if you're singing and playing, you don't have to do that riff. But for more of you advanced players, I'm going to break this down for you. So what you do is you're here with your ring finger on the G string. So you hit that note, and then you also hit the B string directly after. So it's kind of like you're tuning. Then you do a hammer on the 3rd fret with your index. So you're going to go. Then it's like you're tuning that note. So you do the 5th fret and then the high E, the open E, like you're tuning. Then you go 5, 3, 1. So the whole thing kind of rolls in a nice way with some overtone there. Okay, so one time through for the intro, and then we're going to do 4 times through that for the verse. Okay, and what I was referring to was the... Okay, so that was one time. That would be the intro. Then we'll do 4 more times of that, and then that completes the intro and the verse. Then we're in the chorus. And for the chorus, you're going to stay on the G, doing the double. We're gonna slide up, do another double, so that would be A major. Then we're gonna slide up and do that B minor on the 7th fret, so the single. Then back to that double, that A. Okay, so G, A, B minor, A, G, A, minor, and then we go all the way up to that D, which was on the 10th and 11th fret, okay? So you'll do that 2 times, that sequence, and then we're in the instrumental jamming. That's where I break out the pick, and I go G, A, B minor, D. We do that twice. Now these are all just downs for the chorus and for the instrumental section. It's all downs. And once again, on that instrumental section, it was just G, A, B minor, D, two times, okay? Then we're gonna go back to the verse four times through on the B minor, the D, the G, four times of that. And then we're back into the chorus again. Kind of like using my thumb for this part. Save a little energy for the instrumental. Okay, so what I did there is the same thing on the first chorus. It's just G, A, B minor, A, G, A, B minor, D, times two. So you do all that twice. And then we're in the instrumental again. G, G, A, B minor, D, G, A, B minor, D. Okay, and then we just finish the song with one last mellow chorus, and you can either finger pick it like we were doing for the verses, and the chords for the chorus again are just G, A, B minor, A, G, A, B minor, D. So you do that times two, and that's how the song ends. All right, guys, thanks for watching. We'll see you on the next one.